Liberace, Aruba Liberace, Aruba Liberace, play mambo for me. Aruba Liberace, Aruba Liberace, Aruba Liberace, it's wild, you will agree.
John Dillinger, in hope he is still alive. Thanksgiving Day, November 28, 1986. Thanks for the wild turkey and passenger pigeons destined to be shit out through wholesome American guts. Thanks for a continent to despoil and poison. Thanks for Indians to provide a modicum of challenge and danger. Thanks for vast herds of bison to kill and skin, leaving the carcasses to rot. Thanks for bounties on wolves and coyotes. Thanks for the American dream to vulgarize and falsify until the bare lies shine through.
Sometimes there could be things that I could share with you. Sometimes I feel I could even trust you. Sometimes I think I could even love you. But I could tell you right now. It's my bidding upon my own doing. I must tell you. We have an absolute breath of fresh air here with us tonight. Yes, dear. She's the absolutely enchanting little duck. Do introduce yourself.
My vampire arrived with passion. Why is that old fashioned? Are you the vampire that appeared in my dream when I was 16? The king is dead. We've come for his head. The queen has bled, but not from her head. Lonely in her big queen bed. The princess asleep in the tower unseen. Became a single bed queen. This was not her dream.
May I ask a question, please?
I cannot let him inside me now. I can only cry. It is why my thighs are dry. I've not been played with in a while.
What is it that she speaks of queens in bed?
This
and
is strange. Now the truth came.
Oh, dear, dear heart.
I am quite transfixed on these stories you speak of, this tale you tell. I understand I got dries of thighs and queens in the beds. Please enlighten.
China doll had to get broken. I broke her. Made chips in her skin. Her teeth went rotten. Soiled her dress. Sometimes she was perfectly pressed, but I made a mess. China doll got broken. It was the only way we woke her.
You sound a little distressed about this, dear. I am quite concerned for your well-being.
You keep me away from you. You're afraid my bad luck will rub off on you. My nakedness disturbs you. You don't want to go there, too. It'll ruin the illusion of you.
Therapy. Yes, let me take... That's with a P, you say.
Yes.
I see. Could I backtrack for one sec?
I may be a virgin or I may be a whore. I'm still not sure. Punished for both and maybe for more.
I feel this is a soliloquous metaphor.
You may be a whore, or maybe it's just a metaphor.
Myself, you say?
I can hold out for long.
She's
maybe because I'm a Capricorn.
Oh, dear goodness, she's holding out on us.
We want you to be strong. We'll reject you some more. Eat this. It tastes bitter, but it's food for you. Pass it through. Make it your stool. Have a psychic enema. It's good for you.
Oh, my goodness.
I wrote a new play from the old one, and now I've got to go on.
Oh, do tell us. Quite really, I do seem to have a question for you. I... something I... I do... I... I do have something for you to answer for me. We've discussed China dolls. I do see like a sort of change in your demeanor. What is this all about? Is there something you need to discuss?
There is no one else like me. It gets very lonely to be seen and never seen by another human being. If it's Protestant guilt, it's not Catholic. It's PG. It's passed down in the family. It makes me sick. How do I get over it?
Have you seen a doctor?
You're Protestant. It's not a picnic. Get over it!
I see. Is this a religious thing? Your sickness, your illness?
There's no sex in my family.
No sex.
No one ever has sex in my family. We're Protestant. We don't think like that.
No.
It's out!
Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely. Continue.
For a decade, Joan and Julie Kessler have been seen before audiences throughout Beaver County and the state. They have performed on the Eugene Jelesnik Show. They are accompanied by their lovely mother, who is also a great service to the Beaver community, who helps many people sing and accompanies them as they do so. Joan and Julie Kessler, who are a sophomore and junior at Beaver High School, will now sing The Happiest Girl in the Whole USA.
I know you. you, handsome man, you. Good looking tiger, ain't he? Whoa! Help! Oh! I'm not that happy, am I? My blood, you know? Oh, look! Oh, help! Oh, please! Ah! Oh, no!
Wasn't that just terrifying? Wasn't that just sexually arousing? Wasn't that just frightfully, amusingly erotic?
Girl dolls have a home. Girl dolls can be controlled.
You discussed, you tell us about holes.
I damaged the decor. I fell to the floor.
I see.
I'm a broken figurine off the mantelpiece. That's how a doll becomes deceased. But I can never call the police.
I see.
Who should Janet be? Maybe she'd be a secretary.
You tell me.
All right, Janet's still out there somewhere, living a parallel life to mine, living a lie in my mama's mind.
I see.
I would far rather be ignorant than wise, but I'm not. If I could take back that step then, I would, but I can't. Bipeds, you don't know the chaos that hangs in your wake. It's so easy for you, but I know things I cannot know. I have been called upon to perceive and extinguish the tiny fires of unchecked fate. Fat with blindness, you stumble on. Your arms outstretched. You're gonna get hurt. Once I walked in your world, and oh, the damage I caused. Inexcusable. You see, 16 years ago, I stepped on a crack, and I broke my mother's back.
This fork is good. Three times. Three times are important. Four times are bad. It could be deadly.
the child safe? Don't go into the house. Joked with radon.
Oh yeah, the kid's fine. You can't smell radon, boy.
Russ, I forgive you. I forgive you all.
Joyce! It's a blank! Joyce! Les Franches! Les Jouis! French Joyce! Le Blanc! Joyce! Joyce Le Blanc! Joyce!
Who's free to light from any height of rapid flight, stoops at all game that wing the skies. Joyce LeBlanc, my Joyce LeBlanc, my bright-eyed, wild-eyed falcon. Whither, whither fly ye? What game spy ye? Oh, Joyce LeBlanc.
Another, had a brother, succeeded on the second try, had the apple of her eye.
Introducing old man Bickford, cattle, oil, real estate. He owns a big piece of a big state. He's one of the poker-playing, whiskey-drinking, evil old men who run the United States of America. To these backstage operators, presidents, ambassadors, and cabinet members are just jokes and errand boys. They do what they are told to do or else. His subordinates never know why they have fallen from favor. That is for them to figure out. Just Stanford knows he is in trouble when the old man steers him into a little side room with one chair. The old man sits down and smiles. You know, Jess, I've got an intuition about you. I think you'd make a mighty fine president. Jess turns pale. Oh, no, Mr. Bickford, I don't have the qualifications. I disagree with you. I think you do have the qualification. You got a big mouth. Now Jess knows he talked too much at the wrong time to the wrong people. Please, Mr. Bickford, I got a bad heart. The job would kill me. Hey! Bickford, smile wide.
Diaper me. Don't desert me. You feel your ovary ovulating. Month. This month it's on the left. You're feathering your nest. Rub the stone between your legs. It'll ripen all your eggs. Then he'll impregnate you, create a baby or two. How much water will this seed need in order for me to proceed? We'll make a potion to match your devotion. You seem to be of the pagan persuasion. We've made this night a magical occasion. When you enter, it's bumpy, so breathe. We mixed a potion to make you conceive.
I conceive.
Genevieve!
Continue.
Then he wrapped his knees around me.
Knees. The horse.
He's her Dracula. He's spectacular.
Are you okay? Please get her something to drink.
He had a battery of tests. The bat had fertilized her eggs. You've written you a litter. Consider writing a babysitter.
I see. What you're saying is there is a dual personality here.
Yes. No more keeping your paint unwashed like loads of dirty dishes. Wash yourself out.
No washing.
But my plates weren't eaten off of.
Your plates?
They're still too clean.
Ah.
They don't need a washing machine.
No.
I've never tasted great. No one's eaten off my plate.
I don't think anyone will, dear.
Why would you say that to me?
I said nothing of the sort.
Yes, you did!
You're having a moment.
I'm not having a moment!
Calm your
nerves. No, I'm not!
Janet lived someone's life for her! While Janet lived, no one romanced her!
Her.
My name is Genevieve. Make it up to me!
It's a very enclosed set and I'm very delicate with the ears.
Oh, you're delicate.
I'm delicate.
You've just insulted my plate!
I insult none of the sort.
Yes, you did!
Hush.
Why are you telling me to hush?
Hush yourself.
Genevieve can talk.
Genevieve's
not a doll!
Who is this person I speak of here? I am confused. There is Janet. There is Genevieve. No one's pumping horses that I can see, and that's what I was expecting. I see snakes. I hear of St. Patrick's. I see the St. Patrick's hat. I do not hear of anything about the snake of anything of the such.
Dual personality. We have breakthrough.
We'll put it on a cover. To see what you can do.
And when you smile for the camera, they're gonna tell me love it. They're gonna say they love it, we love it, we love it.
Girl, it will come back to you. Girl, it will come back to you. Then the shutter falls, you see it all.
Supposed to get better.
You're getting quite better, dear. It's taking time. You're not allowing yourself.
Allowing myself what?
You're not allowing yourself the moment to actually take it in.
So what are your credentials?
My credentials.
What kind of school have you been to?
I do not need school.
Oh?
I have been schooled by the universe itself.
Where is your diploma?
It is in a drawer. Continue.
Well, how am I supposed to know that I'm better?
Because you should feel it if you weren't so annoying right now.
I am not annoying.
You are flippant.
I have paid you $200 for this hour,
because
and I am not feeling any better!
If you would calm yourself, dear.
I am not feeling better!
Calm yourself, dear.
I am feeling better!
Put up quite a wallop, I tell you.
Well, I am a Churchill.
Yes, I hear the Churchill women are quite aggressive. Yes,
especially in wartime.
Right. Could someone get me a bandage, please?
It was such a lovely evening.
Yes.
And you see, there are no hard feelings. So I get to be more careful next time. I know it makes me a very bad girl to attack my therapist.
Can I borrow $20, please?